you can see here, you know, this is, we had core synergistics in V9X, this is X2 core, so you can just tell by some of these movements, right, you're doing some pretty fun stuff. You're adding plyometrics to core movements, you know, and of course you've got modifications. It's just sort of the next level of core synergistics.
Yeah, and a lot of the program is really, as you'll see, functional. Now here, this one is going to kill people, plyocide.
Yeah, plyocide, I got the red shoes on for this one, baby, you know, so. More Tracy and Mark, you know, and I don't think it would have been the same sense. But the idea here is, you know, the great thing about this one is you're moving more laterally. I know in P90X it was, you know, more about jumping in one spot, but we're moving side to side more, and we're going for more vertical height too, which is really important when it comes to plyometrics.
Recovery mobility. There's a foam roller.
Here's our foam roller. There's poor Cedric. Oh, he's trying. Cedric, don't cringe so much. But right, you can see our modification here. We've devoted an entire DVD to the importance of recovery. And you're allowed, you can see the different versions, that's the death version of Isabel there with spikes in it.
Yeah.
But it's an amazing, incredible tool.
I love that thing, it's super soft.
And you know, it's above and beyond stretching, it really is. Stretching is phenomenal, yoga is phenomenal, but this takes it to the next level.
All right, total body.
Total body is just like it sounds, you know, you're doing, if you have one arm, bicep curls in Warrior 3. Hello! You're doing crunch, you're doing pull-ups, your whole body is crunched. You're doing plyometric push-ups on a stability ball, you know, and Jeremy Yost beat me there. That was brutal for my ego. But you know what's fun about that is, how about that? So, you know, again, the reason why it's 5 days a week is because almost, I'd say 95% of the exercises, everything's involved. It's not just chest or just shoulders.
And that actually what makes it more athletic, because when you're out there, you're not moving one body part when you're doing some move on the field. You've got to be able to react. You've got to be able to move sideways. You want to be able to recruit the right big movers with your stabilizers in order to perform.
And you want to build that foundation. You want to build that strength along the process. You're also building speed and agility and power. And also, you know, that lateral vertical movement. You're tapping in parts of your legs and your butt that you haven't seen.
And how can you improve on that?
Well, you know, there's Fiber Scissors with an added reach. If you were in my workout the other day, you saw that. You know, I pitched an interesting combination of some things that folks have seen in Yoga Belly 7 for P90X. And we've added a lot of stuff where you're up, like the Mason Twist, for example. We're up a lot, up on our butt, because you're forced to use your core that way. So it's a brand new mix. It's a brand new effort for X2, and it'll be just as brutal as the first one.
Now, you talk about core, balance and power X2 is coming up, X2 yoga.
Oh, your friend Crane there. What I did we had a lot of conversations about this, but when it came to the P90X2 yoga, we wanted to get back to basics a little bit. We wanted just a constant flow, you know what I mean? So we took out some of the standing balance moves. We got busy right away, you know, the warm-up was a little bit shorter. And we wanted to condense the very best of the best moves that I think are most effective in yoga in the course of about an hour and 5 minutes.
Last time it was done as a retreat. So they had the whole vinyasa phase in the first 45 minutes. And then we were standing on our heads and our fingers were up our noses.
Yeah, which is really important. Well, you know, it's crazy. Last night, I was walking through the hallway. I had my own workout and I wanted to take yesterday was yoga day for me.
Doing yoga, you know, Crown Room 3,
and all of a sudden 35 people showed up. So, you know.
All right, now I'm talking balance and power, which is your core. That is my favorite move in this whole thing.
That move is crazy. Well, you know, balance and power is exactly what it is. You know, you're adding balance components and strength components at the same time. Usually, you'll see them separately. There's a little chatter.
Look at that. Outrageous.
Outrageous. Yeah, that doesn't require anything whatsoever. So, you know, it doesn't look like much, for example, that one where you're on your forearms, but oh my God, get to your 10th one. And oddly enough, the beautiful thing is you can feel your core working without having to get on your back and work your core specifically, right? So, as a result of that, a lot of those moves you just saw, your quads are engaged, your glutes are engaged, your pelvis is tilted, your core is firing without having to actually do crunches, which are important as well. You see those and have it. But, you know, we're just trying to help people become more athletic, become stronger, and in the process, become gorgeous as well.
Well, my experience, personally, with this versus other kind of ab moves, this one, I, tendency to get really tight in the lower back, right? So these kind of moves, a lot of plank moves, and just fixes my lower back pain. Like, it's just fixed.
Right.
So I'm excited about that. In all the sets of core work, anybody who, if you sit a lot, you work a lot, lower back tightens up, and I think you're going to feel some relief by strengthening it this way versus just doing it.
Well, you know, it's amazing how much we've learned in 7 years when it comes to just doing a standard push-up. You know, like today, like the other day when we were in my workout, you know, you never heard me cue things like flex your quads, drive the back, you know, your backs to your knees toward the ceiling, and turn your heels back, and tilt your pelvis towards your elbows. You know, I mean, we cued it as best we could based on what we knew at that time, but we've learned so much in the interim that, you know, when you see folks now do, and P90X2, you see them do a push-up, they're like this steel rod from head to heels, you know, and that's the idea. And it requires, you know, some new philosophy to be able to do that. And when you do it by yourself, you prevent that injury. Because so many people have that lower back slap when they're doing their push-ups because their focus is too much on numbers. Now we're focusing more on form. And when you do that first, your numbers will go up, but you also not get hurt and you're engaging everything.
I saw that. Everybody was so strong in the room, I actually ran across everybody. Chest, back, and ball ends.
Yeah, we had to check chest, back, and balls for the one-on-ones, but we thought for the masses we should probably end up. So it's called balance now. Yeah, there are levers, there's push-ups from your fingertips, there's four ball push-ups, you know, and trust me, when I first started doing that in particular, it took me like 8 or 9 times to get 2 or 3 reps. And that really pissed me off.
That's what's cool. That's what, you know, you get P90X2, people go, oh boy, you know, $120 or whatever, and they make it for 7 DVDs. This isn't a thing that it's like one and done. You're going to do this for years.
Yeah.
And kind of like all the programs, you go back to them. Even still with Power 90, you go back to it, you're lifting a different weight. You get a whole, just a completely different experience out of it. This is so rich. This is 2 years of richness that people are going to experience as they do this over and again, back and forth with P90X, P90X2, working in Insanity, working TurboFire, working in Asylum. It's like, you got the coolest gym on the planet right now, Steve.
Absolutely. Much more sophisticated than they were back in the old days. Back in the old days, it was either do nothing